Good morning. I welcome you as we gather to worship in the name of Jesus Christ, the coming King. What a joy it is to welcome you here today. I'm Chris. I'm part of the ministry team here at Crossgates United Methodist Church. It's always a blessing and an honor to welcome you as we gather, especially for this service of lessons and carols. What a joy it is to be here today and to share in the many gifts and graces that God has bestowed upon those who will be leading us in worship today. And we give thanks for them offering themselves to us. There are a couple of announcements that I do need to share with you and do need to make. One, you'll notice that there is a yellow card called our connection card that's in the bulletin there that you have. I invite you all to fill that out, especially if you're visiting with us for the first time. We would love to have some information to be able to follow up with you after this service. Note that there are no Wednesday night activities this week, and so there's no need to share the fact that you'll be at our meal, because there will not be one. But also, you are asked if you'd like to offer a prayer concern. There is a place on the back. And as always, there is a place if you are a person who gives digitally. The QR code is on the back there that has instructions for you to be able to give in that way. What a blessing it is to welcome you. You'll also notice the poinsettia list and those who have donated for in honor and memory of many people. The poinsettias will be available for pickup following our Christmas Eve service. At the close of that service, you will be invited and welcome and encouraged to take those home with you at that time. But what a blessing it is to share that information and to have that before us. Well, we were scheduled this evening to do Christmas carols at the prayer chapel, which is outside, which is wet and cold and windy. And in the sense of making an executive decision this morning that was amened by a couple of people, we encourage you to go home and sit by your fire with your family and sing Christmas carols this evening, because Tom Sorrell and I do not want to be visiting you in the hospital next week because of pneumonia. So we thank you for your preparations for that. But tonight is canceled. We will not be going to the prayer chapel to sing Christmas carols. We will, however, be worshiping here on Christmas Eve at 5:30, where there will be Christmas carols involved. So we invite you and your family to come and join us for that special time of worship, which includes Holy Communion as well. So please join us for that. Just a note about the next two Sundays, which just happen to be Christmas Day and New Year's Day. We will be having one service on Christmas Day and New Year's Day at 10:30, and you'll see the announcement toward that on the green sheet that's located in your bulletin. So please note that and some other important information on that green sheet that I invite you to share. Today it's an honor for me to welcome and to introduce to you Katie Geed, who is a seminary student at Asbury Theological Seminary. Katie is from Hattiesburg, Mississippi, living in Wilmore, Kentucky presently. She is one of the recipients of the Dorsey and Mary Gibbs Scholarship that has been awarded from our church here, and we are praying for Katie. Now you have a face and name to go with the name you've been praying for. Katie, we welcome you and pray God's blessings upon your journey at seminary. Help me greet Katie. Well, what a joy it is to worship in this place and to give glory to God, the one who comes to give us life and hope. I invite you to join me as we begin our worship with our opening hymn. Will you please stand?
Set thy people free from our fears and sins. Release us, let us find our rest in thee. Israel's strength and consolation, hope of all.
During Advent, we wait for the coming Savior, the one who is our Prince of Peace, who gives us strength to his people and blesses them with peace. In the midst of conflict, we look to the one who brings harmony.
In the midst of confusion, we look to the one who brings good.
In the midst of division, we look to the one who brings unity.
In the midst of separation, we look to the one who restores the broken.
Today we light four candles, reminding us of Christ our hope, Christ the way, Christ our joy, and reminding us that Jesus is our Prince of Peace. In a world filled with conflict, tension, and discord, we live for the peace that comes through Christ alone.
Let us pray. Gracious Lord, as we continue our Advent journey, we acknowledge that our surroundings are far from peaceful. By your Spirit, help us to be agents of peace in the world around us. Throughout this season, continue to fill us with the peace that surpasses all understanding. We pray all of this in the name of our everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor, Almighty God, Emmanuel. Amen.
Join me as we pray. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, Prince of Peace, the one who has given us life and life eternal. What a blessing it is to gather this day to celebrate the season that lies ahead, the season of Christmas, where we enjoy and share life together with friends, but yet in the midst of it all, celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. As we gather in this beautiful place, we know that you are in our midst. The thing that we want most this day is that you will open our hearts to worship you. Help us to lift our praise. In the midst of this season where we celebrate Emmanuel, God is with us. May someone's heart and life this day be touched by your presence. May come to know Jesus Christ, the living Lord. And may their lives be transformed by it. Use us this day for that purpose, O God, and help us to draw nearer to you. Lord, as we gather in this place, we're mindful of the many ways that people struggle, and for those who continue to battle illness and disease, those who are facing surgery, those who've lost loved ones, and we lift each of them into your care. God, this morning we lift the concerns that are lifted in our prayer book as we pray for Beverly Sagas and Fran Rester, for Jessica Watson and Margaret Whitehead, for Shay Burley as she has surgery to remove her appendix tomorrow, and for Valley Castle also facing surgery this week. Continue to offer hope and strength. Continue to walk with us. Oh God, be with us in the name of Christ, the one who gives life and the one who has taught us to pray as we now say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. May we continue our worship with the giving of our tithes and offerings. A reading from Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 15 and verses 17 through 19. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of thee in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman thou gave to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all cattle and above all wild animals. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." And to Adam he said, "Because you've listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth to you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. You are dust, and to dust you shall return."
Oh, A reading from Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 through 9. There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see or decide by what his ears hear, but with righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Righteousness shall be the girdle of his waist, and faithfulness the girdle of his loins. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and calf and lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall feed, their young shall lie down together, and lion shall eat straw like the ox. The suckling child shall play over the hole of the asp, and weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea.
To us, Emmanuel.
A reading from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 35. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no husband?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God."
With a
A reading from Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and that all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Oh,
A reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 16. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger.
Thank you.
A reading from Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 through 11. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And assembling all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it is written by the prophet, 'And you, O Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who will govern my people Israel.'" Then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word that I too may come and worship him." When they had heard the king, they went their way. And lo, the star which they had seen in the east went before them till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. And they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
A reading from John chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and apart from Him, nothing came into being that has come into being. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There came a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify about the light, so that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but he came to testify about the light. There was the true light, which, coming into the world, enlightens every man. He was in the world, and the world was made known through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and those who were his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, even to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glory as of the only begotten from the Father, full of grace and truth. We give thanks to God for the many gifts that have been given. One more time for the choir, please. And this day is always made so special from the musicians who give of their time and form the orchestra. Would you please help me thank them? Thank you. And certainly our accompanists, Celia and Madeira, who's inside, both. Today is a bittersweet day in that you may be seated for just a moment, in that today is Chuck's last day with us here at Crossgates United Methodist Church. We were talking earlier and he said, "I'm just ready to take a day off." Well deserved, I might add. And Chuck, we appreciate so much the gifts you've brought to us here at Crossgates, the way you've offered not only your gifts in music, but Christ to us. And for God's presence to be with you on your journey, we give you thanks, especially for staying with us through this day, and we are so appreciative. May also just share, yes, please, for Chuck. Chuck said I could do this real quickly. We will welcome a month from today, on January the 18th, Joey Wilkinson, who comes to be the Director of Worship, Music, and Communications in a full-time position here with us here at Crossgates. So we've got Christmas Day and New Year's Day and maybe another Sunday or two that Mitch is going to help me fill in, and then we'll be right back on track getting ready for Easter. And the wonderful time to share that. We are so blessed by your presence here today. We are so blessed by what God is doing in the midst of our life together as a congregation here at Crossgates United Methodist Church. And what a blessing it is to celebrate this season. May you know the peace that only Jesus Christ brings. And may you share that peace with the world around us. Go forth in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.